First of all, thank you everyone. This farewell party is amazing. The setting is really wonderful. I see that. I can see that you guys have worked very hard for this. And thanks a lot. It's way better than what we came up last year. Last year only a few of us worked, mainly Rajibul and some of the guys. I don't really know, but this is really, really, really good. And talking about my experience here, basically I have completed my bachelor's in mechanical engineering. So coming to aerospace engineering, a lot of people have told me that you've made a really bad choice. And I had plans for higher studies after this, go for a PhD after that. So in the first semester, things were really hard because there are new subjects like flight mechanics and all that. I hated that stuff. I seriously hated my city. Who cares? I don't give a shit about it. And in the second semester, things got really, it got easy, a bit more easy, because it was subjects that I liked, aerodynamics and all that. But after the second semester, some personal issues happened, and I lost total focus of what I wanted. So pretty much the entire third semester, I was just sitting around. And that moment, at the end of second semester, when all those, and that slight tragedy happened, that's when I started distracting myself. That's when I got into exercising and all that. And that's it. And after it, but I realized that things had to change when for the end semester presentation. The day before the presentation, I went and saw my guide advisor, and he kind of scolded me like a lot. So, and that's when things slightly started to change, and I started working on my project diligently, and that's it. But in between, it was always a confusion, when you lose focus, it's really hard to get control. I did not want a job here. I wasn't really interested in a job, but I sat for placements anyway. And one thing, I realized things had to change after the Mercedes interview. I mean, it was probably one of the most shameful experiences of my life. But after that, things got better. Now I'm in a much better place, and that's it. That's my experience here. So what I would like to say to you guys is if you have a goal, if you have any dream, just focus on it. You'll have a lot of distractions coming along your way. You'll have your friends getting placed with very good packages, stage 10 lakhs. I mean, I should mention it here, but that's really good. Some friends of mine got placed in very good locations, Bangalore and all that. I mean, it seems very appealing, but you have to focus. I mean, if you have a dream, it's not so easy to attain it, but keep that in mind. And that's it. That's my personal experience. And I would like to say to my classmates, and you see, I've completed my education in class, so pretty much everybody has the same mentality here. So Pallus, basically you can group them. It's just one group with a group mentality. But coming here, I realized that there are different varieties of people, Pallavi, I met her in the first sem. We had our differences. We kind of had a little fight and all that, but yeah, we settled it. Tejveer, and this is a man that I want to talk about. He's a real struggler. He is someone who wants something so bad, and he would do anything to get it. And I was genuinely really happy when he got placed in Honeywell. And I could, it was during the Mercedes interview when he came up, and I asked him how did the interview go, and he was like, and there were slight tears in his eyes, and I realized that yeah, maybe he got it, and I was so happy for him. And the girls, Akila and Danya, very sweet people, and all of them, I just got to interact with them superficially, not very deep, and all those three. Those three were Rajibul bhai, he's brilliant. One thing about Rajibul, you guys had seminar these two semesters, right? Seminar where a total of 4 presentations.
Yeah.
You know what Rajibul did? Rajibul, 4 seminars, he presented the same topics.